Nuclear envelope is a layer of two concentric membrane, inner and outer nuclear membrane, that surround the nucleus and its underlying intermediate filament lattice, the nuclear lamina. Nuclear envelope is penetrated by nuclear pores. The outer membrane is continuous with the rough endoplasmic reticulum, where nuclear protein must be transported from their site of synthesis in the cytosol through the nuclear envelope into the nucleus. Next, function of nuclear envelope. Nuclear envelope is freely permeable to ions, nucleotide, and other small molecules. It also provides a mesh or molecular sieve that permit passage of material below the 50 kilodalton of mass. But globular protein, which has molecular mass of 50 kilodalton, which can be easily flow through, okay, because of its nature of their spherical structure. Proteins more than 50 kilodalton in size do not enter the nucleus by passive diffusion. A mechanism of active transport must be required for their transport. In that case, RAN protein, a monomeric G protein, is needed. And monomeric G protein attaches with the GTP to form an active complex. But when it attaches with the GDP, it will be inactive complex. Active complex is present in the nucleus, and inactive complex means RAN GDP in the cytosol. Protein export complexes are stable in the presence of RAN GTP, whereas import complexes of RAN GDP. So export complexes are driven to form in the nucleus and dissociate in the cytosol, whereas reverse is true for the import complex. Now we talk about that nuclear envelope has a passage of which will allow certain substance to be come through or to be come through, I mean import or import export. So this import export goes through via a nuclear pore. That nuclear pore has a nuclear pore complex. This nuclear pore complex, when we look from the upper side, it will look like a rosette structure on the membrane. This proteinaceous structure that extends through the nuclear envelope, providing a channel for bidirectional transport of molecules and macromolecules between nucleus and cytoplasm. It has molecular mass approximately 50 to 50 into 106 dalton. The structure consists of a rosette made of 8 spokes. It is octagonal, that means, and it consists of an upper ring and lower ring and connective 8 lattice connected by a lattice of 8 structures. And now when we are talking about the transport of different molecules and ions, then we have to know that the nucleus and cytoplasm around the region of the nuclear pore complex, surrounding the region of the nuclear pore complex, sharing the same milieu, same ionic milieu. So they are, in case of animal cell, we found that there are 300 pore complex on the nuclear envelope. And now we talk about the structure of nuclear pore complex. We can look into that structure, that total nuclear pore complex, total the diameter of nuclear pore complex from the upper side is 120 nanometer, and the ring itself consists of 8 subunit, 8 spokes are there. These are the radial arms, and coaxial rings are there. Transporter are there, and these are the channels, and this is the inner ring and inner pore. Okay, the radial arms outside the ring may be responsible for anchoring the pore complex in the nuclear envelope. They penetrate the membrane. 8 interior spokes project from the outer side from the ring, closing the opening to a diameter of 48 nanometer. Okay, next we look through the two-fold symmetry from the side view of the transport complex, where we can see that it will divide the scaffold into 16 identical unit. Each of these unit consists of 30 different proteins, most often each present in 1 to 2 copies per unit. Now we go through the transport mechanism. Transport mechanism via this nuclear transport complex needs two stage. One is docking, another is translocation. Which the component protein of the pore that bind to lectin were originally called nucleoporine. These are the nucleoporine. Docking means, and this protein complex importing is the transporter. RAN GTP is the energy. RAN GTP, which is the monomeric G protein, attaches with the GDB. This portion is in cytosol and this was in nucleus. And this is the substrate has to be imported to the nucleus, which has nuclear localizing signal. These total three component attaches with each other to form this important transport complex. This complex binds to the nucleoporin, attaches to the nuclear pore complex, and it will dislocate it, dissociate its substrate inside the nucleus when RAN GTPs forms. Okay. The lectin binding component are localized at or near the region of the central pore, appear to be located both sides of the nuclear envelope. Some of these nuclear proteins are having motif like GKA, FG, FG. These are all amino acid motif. So it will act as these kind of nuclear proteins are called FG, phenylalanine and glycine nuclear proteins. Okay, next in our syllabus we have nucleolus. What is nucleolus? It is a dark substance, darker area in the nucleolus. So the region of the nucleus where RNA synthesis occurs has a characteristic appearance with a core of fibrillar nature surrounded by a granular cortex area. Now fibrillar core is, what is the fibrillar core? When we look through the micrometrical structure, we can see this region, within this total region there is a more dense region in the inner side and granular like region in the cortex area. Fibrillar region here in the core where the RNA is transcribed or transcribing from the DNA template, continuously transcribing, okay, and the granular cortex is by the ribonucleoprotein, and this granular cortex region is formed by the ribonucleoprotein particles into which the RNA is assembled, and the whole area is called the nucleolus. Okay, and the nucleolar core identifies RNA under transcription, and the granular cortex consists of ribosomal subunits. Now, ribosomes, eukaryotic ribosomes, are assembled in the nucleolus, which is located inside the nucleus. It is a darkly diffused region of the nucleus, where RNA is transcribed and initial stage of ribosome assembly takes place. Some of the ribonucleotide in the RNA are also modified. Some uridine are converted to pseudouridine, and some ribose sugar are methylated. This conversion also takes place in the nucleolus, orchestrated by particles composed of small RNA segments and protein. And in this process, some of other small nucleolar ribonuclear protein particles and small nucleolar RNAs helps in this conversion of pseudouridine to pseudouridine, and some ribosugar to methylated ribosugar. Okay, this conversion takes place in the granular region of the nucleolus. Next, we know that each different SNO SNP has its own SNO RNA. SNO means that small nucleolar ribonuclear protein particle and small nucleolar RNA. This small nucleolar ribonuclear protein and its RNA really surround the nucleotide to be modified. Thus, sites for modification are chosen based on complementarity to a SNO RNA, which then somehow directs the modification to take place. Because a significant amount of protein translation must occur in a cell, large quantity of ribosomes and rRNA are necessary. This quantity is generated by having multiple copies of rRNA genes. And that multiple component of rRNA genes needed that conversion of uridine to pseudouridine and some ribonucleotide, ribose sugar to be methylated. So thus process of conversion that via the help of SNORNP and SNORNA is constantly goes on. Next, we move on to our next slide, where we see that nucleolus, the globular nuclear subdomain formed at the nucleolar organizer, means the chromosomal region that contains tandem repeats of the major three rRNA genes around which the nucleolus forms. Site of ribosome construction. Okay, the nucleolar organizer is the location of rRNA genes, and its chromosomal location differ between species. For example, the fruit fly Drosophila melanogaster has the nucleolar organizer on the sex X and Y chromosome, but in case of humans, were located on the chromosome 13, 14, 15, 21 and 22. It is the nucleolus that the ribosomal protein and rRNA are assembled into the functional ribosomes. The ribosomal proteins are placed in the cytoplasm and migrate to the nucleolus, and the rRNA genes are transcribed and processed in the nucleolus before ribosomal assembly. The most prominent activity is the enzyme RNA polymerase 1, which resides in the nucleolus. You all know about RNA polymerase 1. Is the responsible for transcribing the genes coding for rRNA. It accounts for most cellular RNA synthesis in terms of quantity. Okay, thank you.